the headlines. Two on the trial prisoners' limbs after they allegedly killed another inmate by slitting his throat in Sajiwa jail. And foundation stone for construction of Imphal railway station and tunnel T12 laid at Yoyumba Makalekai. Welcome to ISTV News, now the news in detail. At least three under trial prisoners of Manipur Central Jail at Sajiwa under the jurisdiction of Haingang Police Station were killed in a little fight amongst themselves in the early hours of today. The incident reportedly occurred around midnight last night. The deceased inmates have been identified as Susup, aged 21, son of Siddiqui, Abdul Salam, aged 22, son of late Abdul Aid, both from Saudi Arabia, and Thangmilian Jau, alias Bobon, aged 29, son of late Kakantar from Malom village in Chorachandpur district. The two deceased inmates from Saudi Arabia were arrested by Mori police in 2013 and have been incarcerated in Sajiwa jail under Section 14 of the Foreigners Act. On the other hand, Thangmilian, who was arrested by Chorachandpur police in 2010 under Section 302 of Indian Penal Code, was undergoing trial. According to reports received by the ISTV News, Thangmilian Zaw was allegedly killed by two foreign inmates, Susup and Abdul Salam, by slitting his throat and bludgeoning him using a heavy object. Later, after learning about the incident, other inmates of the jail rose in unison and beat both of them to death. Haingang Police has registered a case in the unusual case of riot and initiated investigation. The three dead bodies have been kept at the Janam's morgue. Railway Minister Suresh Prabhakar Prabhu and Chief Minister O. Ibobi today laid the foundation stone for the construction of Imphal Railway Station and Tunnel No. 12 at Yoyumba Makalekai. Deputy Chief Minister Guy Khangam, Minister of State for Railway Rajan Goen, MP Dr. Mania, MP Thangso Vaitpe, MLAs and other top officials of Ministry of Railways were also present at the foundation stone laying ceremony. Addressing the gathering, Chief Minister O. Ibobi said, "Every developmental works taken up in the state is for the betterment of the people. The state government is making arrangements to extend all possible help in the construction work of the broadways from Tupul to Imphal to ensure that the construction is completed within the stipulated time." He further said, "The proposal to lay a 110-kilometer long railway line from Imphal to Moray is lying pending with the railway board." He appealed to the Prime Minister to ensure that the objective of bringing about development in the northeastern states is achieved as planned.
"It is in the interest of our state, it is in the interest of the nation and the government. So please accept it. They accept it and we are able to hand over to the railway minister with time bound and time record. Extension line from Imphal to Moray. If it is not extended from Imphal to Moray border town, international border town of Moray, the Honorable Prime Minister's dream for achieving it will not fulfill, I hope. Bali is China's border. Muse is major border. They have already started with war footing. They have already started. Before it is laid, we should have to be, with war footing, we should have to be start extension of railway line as a new gift, not old gift, as a new gift to the people of Manipur, to the people of this nation. Without that proper protection, our dream to start commissioning, functioning of this next year, 2017, railway commission, starting of flying railway line from the Imphal, the Jirbaum to this Tupul, I don't know, it may be extremely difficult. I think railway ministries, they might have already worked out for doing all necessary security arrangement, everything. Otherwise, it will be extremely difficult."
At Addressing the gathering, Deputy Chief Minister Gargangam appealed to the people of the Hughes area not to give obstruction to the developmental works in any way. On the other hand, Minister of State Railway Rajan Goyal said efforts are being made to connect the northeastern states through railway lines under the supervision of the Prime Minister. The Railway Minister aims at completing the project by 2020. Speaking on the occasion, Railway Minister Suresh Prabhakar Prabhu said an overall development of tourism can be brought about when the people come close to each other, both physically and mentally. Many projects are being taken up by increasing the fund with an objective of developing the region. Many other projects are in pipeline. He said the Ministry of Finance will be consulted to take up the work of laying the Imphal-Mori railway line.
The station has been designed to bring in the architectural elements of Rangla Fort, Sri Govindi Temples, which are the archaeological sites of Mali. More present the past, but also while I'm finding out how the future should save for betterment of the people of India. And that's the vision of the Prime Minister, that's the vision of this government, that's the purpose for which we are here. We are really proud. In fact, I was telling all of my friends that if you want to see how the real ancient Indian culture has been, you can go to Manipur, where it's like a living museum of an ancient traditional culture, which is practiced by the people despite so many difficulties that are faced in the past. We'll really make sure that every fortnight, every week, this project will be monitored so that we'll not have any reason why there will be a delay or cost or time for it. We'll also take up this project and we'll take up with the Ministry of Finance so that we will get a proper public support. I know my two distinguished members of Parliament will also take up this issue so that we try and take it up as fast as possible.
The 24-hour public curfew imposed by JCILPS in protest against the police action at Sinjamai Tongkong yesterday has completely paralyzed normal life in the valley districts today. All shops and business establishments remain closed at Kwaramban Bazaar due to the curfew. All passenger and transport vehicles stayed off the roads. On the other hand, some women at Pishum Nongthur Mamlekai were seen blocking the road in support of the public curfew. They blocked the road by placing benches, bamboos and used tires on the road. Talking to media persons, one of the women supporters said, "The indigenous people of Manipur are suffering as the leaders of the state government are not fit to govern the state."
Ratan water lau thoki basaya koi aning de amaram chadana chatra sing kubi basai biba habidi kanosing se koi aning de thoi beirang se koi leba kanogi Manipur purlo gi nemasa masagi dai ta ai isa gi na habale te Manipur government so khangum thoi maram di tawriba ILP gi kanosaya ai isa ke pegina te Manipur kaza puna makine na haibe te masi kan sigi public ka se ho me antanar so bachari.
On the other hand, police personnel took up tight security measures in order to prevent any unwanted incident during the public curfew. One Kwairapam Nayansana Devi, aged 42, has been lying bedridden due to paralysis at her maternal home at Langtabalep Makalekai for the last 7 years as her parents could not afford to treat her. She got paralysis on account of deficiency of blood after delivery of her second child. Unfortunately, she lost her husband Basanta in an unfortunate accident in the hills when he went to work to earn money. Unfortunately, she also lost her ability to speak after hearing the news of her husband's death. Speaking to the ISTV News, a neighbor drew attention of the director of Janins to extend all possible help to Nayansana.
Accident the lake it over the key, paralysis, starving the labor says, so he tell any problems food. Mama, look happy, Sinama, Sani, Gama, laying no honor of the lungs. I do not quit me up by my arm. We Jeninski, the medical director, the authority that when a marble lying be worn. I said, may I be quit my arm? I said, him on the matting be no be worn.
Despite efforts of the State Armed Department to modernize Manipur Police, Tamai Police Station in Temenglong District remains in a deplorable condition. Police personnel at the station are worried that the building may collapse anytime as it has remained unrepaired ever since it was constructed. The roof of the building not only leaks during rainfall but has also become very weak. The condition of the building came into notice when a team of media persons visited the station recently. talking to media persons, inspector in charge N. Soba said, even as the higher authority has been requested to repair the station building, no work has been taken up so far.
Station khalaga madu umba osidu lewa piu hauta agadi tamai se amani haibda haiman muthwa tamasung lewam sahun dadi akhoi aina sahi kuntra mai muk service tor khosta tamai police station si tamai district ko khudung inawa amoina asuki matip lewam sahun si matik cha de sipai sing ki officer sing ki masi aina ai ithak thong sing ba complaint tok jabi wa mate kai meeting ko ada duga sp masamak lakna su yeng ba Sabirmiba, Idi building construction is Sabirmiba, conductor Duda, Hanana Hire Kole, Aigi Takumusu, Aisho Hire of Nagi Levenda, Amamba, Aigi, Matin Pang, Shemjena, Espinasudum Tapi Adubo, Nasiba, the DA Kogishi, Mayamazu, Vidunga, Mayamna Haiba, Dudagi, Tadrena, and the Lipse.
Meanwhile, one of the police personnel of the station said many officers have come and gone so far. Even the district commissioner had inspected the condition of the police station. However, no concrete step has been taken up so far.
Asi tawio khotio na janori disu sp masamuk asi sanga yinga sakrebni sp mari sura si yinga kanam so action no bide dc tamino dc masamuk sanga gai haige thekadar kanano ei tap action no bai yawa lobby ge hansa khre mu hoji phone lagte ho kumsi su no su tha yawa asi pho ko tum me yaad re
Police inspector in charge further said the personnel at the station are not issued arms. However, they can always request the higher officials to have arms issued when it's really required, he added.
Hablarma police ka seven para mi tara hondoi aduga bdf na mi kuntret akoi mi ni phumuk le bisi barik amau leke 5 mr le ngai matam da saram ne haba barik macha am khaka aduga building matrix cha deba construction matrix cha deba sida wa ikoi nam jin da na hui ye le dung na le haida hamin ma thukla roi toilet matrix cha de adubu akoi osis na individual na yam na kan na hona da na akoi chokwa chak thungbam chafum sem sabidna akoi te tongham thokpa phidik matichana tobna akoi ngammi mo ka akoi thak tang ngammi mo kai nu nan le na de akoi hon je
right now I'm in front of the Tamil police station. You can see the situation of the police station. There is lots of leakage, batteries and everything. On the other hand, there is no arms to the police station just here deployed here. So we are talking about the modernization of police. You see the situation. So the concerned authority have to look at the such situation and do the needful at the earliest. We come in now. This is Zid Ngomba reporting for ISTV News, Tamil Police Station.
People have been facing a lot of inconveniences while travelling on the Tamanglong Kongsang Road, which has remained unrepaired even as announcements on repairing the road have been frequently made in the past. Talking to the ISTV News, State BJP Executive Member Samuel Zende, who was once a minister, said Manipur cannot be developed without bringing about development in the hill areas. He said this during an inspection visit to the police. Many vehicles were found stranded on the road as they couldn't move forward. Talking to media persons, one of the drivers of the stranded vehicles resented, saying that it takes about 4 to 5 days to pass a 39-kilometer long road. Former Minister Samuel Jindal further said the indifferent attitude of the Congress government has caused a rise of different agitations in the state. Development cannot be brought about in the state by developing only Thobal, he asserted.
Infal Delhi da thobal chokhot panat na Manipur chokhot panat te adibo symptom amat to oina symptom amat to oina par development activities da par leira ga chotha ba matam sida soi da na thoba Manipur oigni hajik tribal movement chotha re tribal movement chotha ba matam sida akoi Delhi da leira ba isin na usin na khalle Kari ke damak leasing ani aku amat tu orang lain menaraga. Kari ke damak ta administrative unit ama separate oga babono hana question tu boleh. Adu bu ayu mesti dia inkaru tu oga babono tu. Adu bu aku ini kerajaan sana. Singun koya yang sin bi ke damak pota yang sin bi de bagi maram oga na. Ma aku ini sentimental oga activities ama haure. Aku ini representative susu. Mahatma, mahi maram bumi. Alhamdulillah, same berbudi. Karena same itu berbunyi. Hai, bisi maju responsif di khanla khanla. Masih lambi lambahan same berba. Yang same berhai bisi mahat ke duty ni. Okey ba, canda ba, amasum cura campu ba. Developmental activity si ba, yam cuthar. Hujit aku na, complain tu bermata ba. Tuh nama ki mata ba. Same berani hari ni, adu bu same berlambat ba. Kini maram digi. Hujit Manipur state se. Financial crunch lay rae. Kuidra bambatam si tulop si pibang ngam lorai. Tulop pibang ngam darabadi. Karamayna, developmental activities si paisa yao darabah. Sangsin gababa haibasi oithok tabani. Naramdina masi sarkar si thajad ro. Madina, moral ground digi. Masi congress left toba. Government masi moral ground digi resign tobaraga. Anna upo sarkar siyemba aduga. Election thirna ba haibasi achumbo oigini.
As part of the initial programs of 2016-17, the Lions Club Imphal City handed over ration to Raja Dumra Anand Ashram Old Age Home Nomoibung yesterday. The ration handing over program was held on the theme, Relieve the Hunger. President of Lions Club Imphal City L. J. Tombi, President of Home K. Binodini and Vice President of Lions Club Imphal City E. Bihari were the main guests at the program. Japanese encephalitis vaccines were given to children between 9 months and 15 years at the 2nd Battalion MR Family Line Quarters and surrounding areas. It was organized under the supervision of CEO of 2nd MR Formwei Gonglin and the unit hospital. Around 400 children were vaccinated by doctors of the unit hospital. It is reported that the vaccines were supplied by the Department of Family Welfare. A one-day free medical camp organized by the Directorate of Ayush and Langol Tarung Youth Club was held at Langol Tarung Community Hall. 8 doctors and 20 paramedical staff took part in the free medical camp. President of the club, Maingam Panmay, said the camp has been organized as the preventive measure for various diseases. Twelve Bihar Regiment of 9th Sector Assam Rifles organized a free medical camp. Around 150 people were given free treatment apart from distributing medicines free of cost, a press release issued by the PRO IZAR South stated. The Grant Hearing Screening Camp 2016 organized by National Program for Prevention and Control of Deafness in Far West in collaboration with ALIMCO, MOS, J&E, Government of India Health at RD Wing Complex Longfell was started from July 20th as concluded today. District Model Officer Dr. Roshan announced that hearing aids will be provided free of cost to those people whose monthly income is less than 15,000 rupees.
Mana tajat raba, tadi income di kami low isaba, makai instrument lebang am jeda ba, kampu sengsi tu koi na free da, si hearing yace panggan ba, tadi masih hearing yace koi na government of India gi makada hai betare, ELIMCO na, Guwahati gi ezen magi makagi through makada koi moga keno collaborator aga tau isaba tu mukim. Masing akang abdi lagi tiap koi gi la ibu kucing makai piba am nawa gi pandam de tau isaba ni.
Leningtau Sanamahi Temple Board Imphal today felicitated Sobham Mayon Lakpa alias Hemanta of Khaziri Maning Nekai Nambol, who is the folk singer of Mitefit, now residing at Thamoiban Sanam Nekai, the recipient of fellowship for folk singer of Mitefit for the first time by the Manipur State Kala Academy for the year 2016-17. Now the headlines once again. Two under trial prisoners lynch after they allegedly killed another inmate by slitting his throat in Sajiva jail. And foundation stone for construction of Imphal railway station and tunnel number 12 laid at Urimba Makalekai. That's all for now and keep watching ISTV News Update. Thank you.